Good evening. Apparently there were issues with the phone locking. Hopefully I handled that. So as I said, I was taken by an ex-girlfriend of mine. Before we started dating, by the way, officially, if I'm not mistaken, she had a friend who was a ranch hand off of 281 North, though you had to take some sort of weird hilly road to get there. And he had been a ranch hand to someone who had miniature donkeys for sale. Irony on that in certain points. As well as goats and horses. If I'm not mistaken, that guy was wanting to transition from male to female. Anyway, later on, well after she and I broke up, you know, that whole Hurricane Katrina thing, and, you know, her stupidity on that. And after her, you know, stalking and all that, when I wound up starting to date Jeffrey Kirkendall Jr., and the one Vivi went grand warriors, he had said we should take 281 North instead of 35. Why would we do that? Why? Why would we take 30? Why? Like, 35 seems perfectly fine. No, because, you know, you don't have to deal with as many vehicles. What do you mean, seeing me? I'm nothing to hide. Well, no, it's not as big of a deal. It's out of the way.
I think you mean it's more out of the country.
And, more natural reasoning. You told me it was less populated. As I always am, I had to look up what less populated meant later on.
Now, okay, that means to like the average person.
Not as many people. But I was right and accurate with the out of the country. Natural settings. I could almost imagine hearing Jeffrey Kirkendall Jr. say shit, shit, shit,
among a few others of his associates.
And that would be me when I ran the ears. So, welcome to the Ornery PSA, hosted by me, Reverend Susan Meadling. Since, you know, gotta say that, right? I mean, honestly, I didn't think I had to say that I was a reverend to anyone. Unless, you know, they had a concern about speaking to someone who was into spirituality. But, last I checked, most reverends, unless they willingly go in front of a specified congregation and or they're on television or news or radio or whatever, there's no need to specify, you know, because it's not a mandatory thing, right? Valley. I think that has something to do with Excalibur.
It's been a while.
Especially since Jeffrey Kirkendall Jr. preferred to go the route of 281 North for some reason. Anyway, I quite perturbed because I realized literally what I told people who claimed that they were my friends, claimed to care about me, claimed to only think about the best of me. When I told them that I had received multiple threats, not one, not two, not even three, a whole bunch of threats with the exact same intent of locking me in a kennel or a cage depended on, you know, threatening message. But basically, where I was locked in an area that was confined at the foot of my captor's bed. If you ever were to see the location of where I was kept and the location of where my now supposed ex-boyfriend, Jesse Lee Rover, slept, the foot of his bed was the wall to where I was locked in. For the past 3 years, you know, not necessarily October of 2018, until I got to the state of Texas, but you know, from August of 2014, 2018. So all of those people who said they cared, all of those people who said I was being overdramatic about online threats, all of those people who said I was attention seeking, don't you find it a little weird of a coinkydink that for that amount of time would be the room that he put a lock on? And his bed was on the other side of that wall. By the way, by the way, only this year did he turn 18. Which means, obviously, he was a minor when he and I were taken out of the state of Texas. After, I had to do what I could to also keep his sister safe, you know, my daughter. We're still alive. So, you know, I hope all of you are up now. I truly do. At least I thought there were laws against kidnapping or disability discrimination. Or does that not happen in the state of Texas either? Don't think of employee injury in Carrollton, Texas, as well as mutual rider. Anyone else associated with those individuals and or that school, Marcy, Sarah, and Rebecca, and any other parent, volunteers of Roy Elementary School in Carrollton, Texas, or how about Anderson, Brown, and Green, Wolfram, just wondering. Individuals in the state of Texas. Just wondering. I mean, it's not like I can at all. So I've been wondering what's taking so long for justice to occur. Others were messing with my Medal of Honor art project, where it really became a big deal when and how much more does it take for justice to occur? Or does it not matter? Because I'm a veteran by technicality. Does it not matter because I'm a female? Does it not matter because my dead ex-husband was a piece of shit and that's being held against me? Or was? Just wondering. It's, you know, been a few years, don't you think? I've sent a lot of letters out. I've made quite a few Aerosmith videos. Unless that's just not convenient either. Action. back then.